You've been following the buzz on all this. Anticipation continues to build as to whether President-elect Obama will select Senator Hillary Clinton, his nemesis of the campaign trail, to be Secretary of State. Although this possibility has been applauded by many, my next guest argues strenuously that she should most definitely not be the one to represent an Obama administration on the world stage. Joining me now, Vanity Fair columnist Christopher Hitchens. Welcome.
Thanks for having me.
We talk about the Obama brand, and a lot of this has been defined by this team of rivals concept, that he can have his enemies close by, and what does that say about him? But it's kind of a theme of the program tonight, as you look at Eric Holder, as you look at the possibility of Hillary Clinton, to ask the question, at what point does the brand of the campaign trail, the Obama brand, get undermined with the selection, particularly of somebody like Hillary Clinton?
Well, yes. Phrasing it another way, how does the idea of change hang with the idea of let's appoint all the friends of Mark Rich? Remember, we're just about to enter presidential pardon season in the Bush term. And I, by the way, thinking ahead a bit, I bet that isn't going to be pretty. I think a lot of people who would otherwise have been indicted for torture and illegality are probably going to be told they can walk. But to remind people at this point of the lowest stage of the Clinton administration, when Eric Holder signed off at the Justice Department on the pardon of this fugitive, shall we call him financier, who'd also given a rather a large loan that didn't seem to have been repaid to one of Hillary Clinton's brothers, who in turn, with the other brother, had gone for a walnut monopoly, or was it a hazelnut monopoly, in the Republic of Georgia, odd bits of the Caucasus involved in American foreign policy here, plus donations to the Clinton Library. It builds up and it goes on. Is this how the president-elect really wants to start?
The question of
if there was some foreign policy experience or brilliance that Hillary Clinton had ever shown, maybe we overlook the fact that she and her husband have never met a foreign political donor they don't like and haven't taken from the Riyadi family in Indonesia to numerous Chinese donors who left this country rather than show up for the hearings on it. But I don't know of any such expertise on her part, except her pretense to have been under fire in Bosnia when she had not.
What worries you about not just Senator Clinton, but the former president having this kind of access to the world stage? It's not that they're going to have their own portfolio. They're still going to be representing the president of the United States, who is hugely as popular as the Clintons are on the world stage. Barack Obama is the it guy right now, arguably,
surely.
No?
Surely, and this is a couple who, it makes me wonder about whether there's a masochistic tendency in the president-elect. This is the couple who openly played the race card on him throughout the election. But even if we overlook that, just look at today's and yesterday's New York Times at the list of people with whom the former President Clinton has acquired a tremendous burden of debt. These are people who pay him all the time, from odd parts of the Middle East to strange donors all over the place. My colleague at Vanity Fair, Todd Purdom, anyone can Google this, just put in Purdom Clinton. See if you can bear to read the sort of friendships that a former president is having. It's undignified to think about it.
And what's the impact on a Secretary of State Clinton because of those associations? Can they not put up a firewall between them?
Well, as I say, if it hadn't involved her too, the campaign finance scandals, we're not talking about the ongoing stuff, Mr. Clinton's huge speaking fees in the Gulf and elsewhere. Talking about previous convictions in the Clinton fundraising scandal, if it wasn't for the fact that she couldn't refuse her brothers anything they wanted, they seem to have got, including some kind of deal for Mark Rich, all of this might be forgivable. It might assume a different proportion, David, if it wasn't for the fact that this woman doesn't really have any foreign policy experience worth mentioning. And what is memorable about it is pretty bad. We all remember, or we should, that when Les Aspin had then got the Clinton administration very nearly to do something about the horror in the Balkans that belatedly the Clinton administration did decide to stop, Clinton-Gore administration, they delayed it because Hillary said, no, no, don't do it. It will take away attention from my brilliant, wonderful healthcare program that we all remember so well. At least on healthcare, she knows enough about the subject to have really changed American healthcare for the worse in her time. About foreign policy, she doesn't even know that much.
But she's respected in the Pentagon. She certainly has an important name on the world stage, and
that's
is
true.
More hawkish than the president she might serve.
It's true that she's got a major name on the world stage. That's true by definition. It's only true that she's respected in the Pentagon if people go around saying so. I'd never heard that before, I must say. On some things, she's more hawkish than the president-elect, yes. But she tends to have acquired this reputation in what I'd call an opportunist manner. I mean, who really thinks that she felt that strongly about Iraq? She just didn't want to cast her vote the other way.
We'll leave it
for
there.
Example.
A lot to follow here. Yeah.
Hope so.
Christopher Hitchens, thank you very much from Vanity Fair. Appreciate it.
Thanks.
Glad to have you on the program.
Ciao.